It's a long-standing German way of war to seek a decisive battle of annihilation, that is to encircle the enemy, then use artillery and infantry to close in on and annihilate the enemy. The Germans managed at Dunkirk to surround the British expeditionary force. All that remained was for German forces to fight inward, destroy the British expeditionary force, and knock Great Britain and its empire out of the war.
Late May 1940. In Dunkirk, a disaster is unfolding. Thousands of British, French, and Belgian troops face annihilation. With the Wehrmacht closing in, the men digging in on the beaches come under attack from the skies. Luftwaffe bombs and machine gun bullets rain down. Total defeat looks inevitable. Then, with victory in sight, one of the most controversial orders of the war is given by German high command. The panzer units approaching Dunkirk are ordered to halt.
General Rundstedt from the German Army Group C argued, well, we have to stop the tanks because the war is not over. There's a second period. We are not in Paris yet, and we have a lot of casualties. We have to stop. We have to give them a pause. The German high command of the army said this is the chance to crush the British expeditionary force. And Hitler said, you know, well, I'm the boss. I take a decision. And because he didn't like Halder and the German high command of the army, he supported Rundstedt and said, no, we are going to pause, we're going to halt.
Though the panzers are at a standstill, the Luftwaffe continues to pound the Allied forces at Dunkirk. The port and beaches come under heavy attack. With each passing hour, the situation becomes more desperate. For the Allies, the only hope is an evacuation. May 1940. Germany's invasion of France and the Low Countries is a resounding success. The BEF and the Allied troops are trapped at the French port of Dunkirk. Back in Britain, an ambitious rescue plan is hastily put together. It's codenamed Operation Dynamo. From the British military base beneath Dover Castle, Admiral Bertram Ramsay directs the top secret operation. But he's faced with a huge problem.
What the British planners very swiftly realised was that you can't just sail a destroyer right up to a beach and get loads of people off it.
What Ramsay needs to evacuate the troops are as many small vessels as possible. He issues a plea for help to anyone who owns a small craft capable of crossing the English Channel.
Dynamo involved this extraordinary policy of asking people to volunteer or requisitioning their little boats, you know, moored at harbours all the way along the southern coast of Britain.
Hundreds answer the call. Soon, an armada of recreational boats, yachts, commercial craft and fishing vessels are ready to make the 20-mile channel crossing. May the 26th, 1940. Operation Dynamo begins. As the Royal Navy and the little ships arrive at Dunkirk, the Luftwaffe maintains their attack on the Allied forces below.
We got back to Dunkirk. I ran along the beach. They were machine gunners again. Me and another chap both fell down. And when I stood up, he had a hole in the back of his head, and he was dead.
When we got to Dunkirk, well, all hell broke loose. It were burning from end to end. It was just absolute chaos.
The German assault keeps coming day after day. Troops in the town, port, and on the beaches try desperately to find their way to the waiting ships.
The beach was black with people, from here up to the drink. So over there, the sea was full of boats and people trying to board them.
During the night, we were told to go out on the mole. It was very dark, apart from all the fires burning. There was oil tanks burning in Dunkirk. See the ship out in the sea. We saw this other boat taking on passengers a little way out, so we decided to swim to that. Jonesy got on, but I went to go on, and the bloke was in charge of the boat. He wouldn't let me get on. But my mate Jonesy got on and he said, if he don't come on, you go off.
Under intense fire, the boats shuttle as many soldiers as possible from the beaches to Royal Navy vessels at sea.
A destroyer came in very quickly, and we were told to jump aboard, and which everybody did. And within a few minutes, the thing was full, and off we went. Some went below, some were on the deck, but everyone just collapsed and went to sleep. Woke up when we got to Dover.
June the 10th, 1940. Operation Dynamo is complete. Admiral Ramsay had hoped to rescue around 10,000 troops. But with the help of the little ships, over 330,000 British and Allied soldiers make it back to Britain.
We were put into a train, and whenever we stopped, people came up with coffee and cigarettes and this sort of thing. We had this tremendous euphoria, really, quite unfounded, that we were some sort of heroes and we won some sort of a victory. I think the mood in the country at the time, certainly for a few weeks, was that won a deliverance. They got soldiers back, and that transcended everything else. It was obvious, really, that we'd been thoroughly beaten. Everybody realized that if they thought about it.